Hey, everyone. Blockchain Bernie here with my latest episode. And this one is about the transaction flow within the Solana blockchain. And it's really a deep dive here. I'll show you how everything works from your app that you're using in the browser. And it goes all the way through the Solana validators. So let's dive right into it. So if we look at what we have here, we have and I call it a Xandeum app, right? So we're with Xandeum. We're building a scalable storage layer based off of the Solana code base. So Xandeum is almost used interchangeably here for Solana. So for Xandeum, it will be a setup. We know the term DAP, right? Decentralized app. In our case, it's a storage-enabled decentralized app. We call that a set app. So that would be a Xandeum-enabled app, but it could be just a Solana app here, right? So this video is about the transaction flow on the Solana chain. So you have that DAP or set app, and it uses a library called Web3.js, right? So Web3.js had its origins on the Ethereum chain, but there's also a Web3.js for Solana, and everyone who's ever created apps on Solana knows that there's that Web3.js, and if you're building your web interface for your app, it's going to use JavaScript, right? Because, yeah, JavaScript is just ubiquitous in each and every browser, so that's why it's JavaScript. And this Web3.js library that you're using, that gives you access to the Solana blockchain, right? And that access works using RPC, right? It's called JSON RPC, and RPC stands for Remote Procedure Call. So RPC is just, you know, JSON RPC is a technology that has been out there for decades, basically. And it's being used on the Ethereum chain as well, and we use it in Solana also. So if you want to send a transaction to the blockchain, you use it from your web interface. You include your Web3.js, which is provided by Solana Labs in this case, and you use the JSON RPC, Remote Procedure Call service, to send your transaction. So the blue thing that you see here is your transaction, right? And let me get that here. So the blue thing is the transaction. And then we have the Xandeum or the Solana RPC node. So the RPC node is a special type of validator. It just means it's a validator node as every other also, but it's especially designed to expose the RPC port to the world, and many app developers can just use that RPC port in order to send their transactions there, right? So it could be a regular Solana node here, or it could be a Xandeum RPC node, because our DevNet is already running. And we have our Xandeum nodes there. So what does the RPC node do? The RPC node is, you know, receiving this transaction. It could be a regular transaction, or it could be a storage-enabled transaction using the Xandeum technology. And that RPC node forwards that transaction to the upcoming leader, right? So Solana has what's called a deterministic leader schedule. So we know what the upcoming leader will be, and the RPC node will forward that transaction to the next leader. And that's another validator node, right? That leader on the Solana blockchain right now, we have a little over 2,000 validators active on mainnet. And just the next leader will receive that from the RPC node in its TPU. So TPU stands for Transaction Processing Unit, right? So in this piece of software here, the transaction will be processed, right? So this is the leader node, and the leader will use that transaction that it just received from the RPC node and include it in the next block, and the leader is the one that produces the next block. So this transaction will be executed, and it will be the result, the new state that it results in, will be included in the blockchain. So now we have that. We have the leader node. The block is being created, but obviously that block needs to be validated by thousands of other validators in order to be, you know, cryptographically safe and have that consensus and all these things that blockchain stands for, right? So in this case, Solana is using their Turbine block propagation engine, right? And that's one of the great innovations that the Solana blockchain has. So if you're interested in that, I can absolutely recommend just Googling 7 innovations Solana, and you find that Medium blog post of Anatoly from, you know, years ago when he started Solana. And read up on that. It's not much to read, but it's actually the basis of so many things. You absolutely have to read that, right? So what happens now after the leader is done and has produced the block? The block is being propagated, right? Like with a multi-layer scheme to all the other validators in the network. It's being propagated really, really fast. It goes into the TVU, not the transaction processing unit anymore, but this is now the transaction validation unit, right? And here we are receiving blocks, not transactions, right? So these blocks then go to these other validators, and they kind of replay everything that has been going on the leader, and replay everything and validate that whatever they received as a block is the correct thing, and then they vote on it, right? So this is how things are working on the Solana chain, and that was my little deep dive. How everything works, and with the special version of the validator, the Xandeum validator that we're building, we can not process only the regular Solana transaction, but we can process the storage-enabled transactions that will offload an external storage to a set of storage provider nodes, right? Because the regular storage on Solana, it's all living inside the validators, and that's the reason it's super expensive. The storage on Solana does not scale, so it does not enable real Web3 apps. And that's the problem that we're solving here at Xandeum. We are building that storage layer that offloads the actual storage to a set of way, way more storage provider nodes than there are validator nodes, right? So we aim to have tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands, and ultimately millions of storage provider nodes all over the world that are, you know, running on relatively cheap hardware and are just dedicating their drives, like their terabytes of drives, to the storage network. And these storage provider nodes are being supervised by the validator nodes. And obviously that has to be a Xandeum-enabled validator node that can monitor and supervise these storage provider nodes. So, yeah. And that picture that I showed you, that's the transaction flow through the Solana blockchain. It's something that we figured out how it all works through the source code of the Solana validator. The reference implementation is the Solana Labs client written in Rust, and we have our Rust development team here in order to build that storage layer right into that validator code. And we couldn't be more excited to get this stuff going and keep you all up to date on how things develop. So if you want more news about that, you know, I have monthly updates each and every month. I let you know right here on this channel where we are with the Xandeum blockchain. So you don't want to miss out on that. So please subscribe to my channel, hit that bell notification. Also give me that like button, which is ever so important for the YouTube algorithm. Also, if you have any more questions, that's what we have the comment section for, right? So if you have questions, comments, you want to know more, you want to know where can you learn more or stuff like that, leave me all that in the comments and we can discuss there. And also go to Xandeum.com, top right corner. You can join our Discord there. You can sign up for our email list, which I recommend because there's upcoming offers for those storage provider nodes. And yeah, for today, thanks so much for watching. Catch you guys later, and peace.